It is certainly an honor and a privilege to be able to bring you a word from the Lord once again. God is certainly an awesome God, and He confirms His word, and He knows what we need when we need it. And I just want to thank Him this morning for His grateful, for His grace and His mercy that endured from generations to generation. I am grateful to be in the land of the living on this morning, not as pain and achy as I was yesterday, but God has been faithful. Oh, let's go to the throne of grace on this morning. Mighty God, I want to thank you for your love, for your mercies and your grace that are new every day. I want to thank you that God, you saw it fit for us to be in the land of the living once again, oh God, with our hearts and minds stayed upon you. Father God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, my strength and my redeemer. I pray that you give us listening ears and hearing hearts on this morning. We thank you, we praise you, and we honor you for the word that will go forth in Jesus' name. Amen. This morning, our devotion is entitled, What is Your Role? What is Your Role? And we'll be looking at Ephesians chapter 4, verses 15 and 16. And it reads thus, But speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, who is the head, even Christ. From whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. Praise be to God. What is your role? Ephesians 4:16 tells us essentially that the parts of the body of Christ is fitly joined together and every part works together in unity that brings about the enhancement of the kingdom of God. The question this morning is, what is your role? What part are you playing in this process? In a play, every character has a role that they play to bring about the message that the writer is trying to portray. Sometimes the major roles have understudies that learns the lines of the main characters. In case of a mishap, in case the main character falls sick or there's something, there's concession made, there's a plan B in case of something that might go wrong. We are called to emulate and imitate Christ in our daily walk as children of God. 1 Peter 2:21 tells us, For you have been called for this purpose, since Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example for you to follow in his steps. Isaiah 43, verse 10, Ye are my witnesses, saith the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, that ye may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me, there was no God formed, neither shall there be any after me. We are called to be understudies for Christ, so we can know him and do the exploits that Daniel 11:32 speaks about. What part are we playing in the story that is being told? What part are you playing in the story of your life? John the Baptist knew his part. He knew that he was the forerunner. Daniel knew his part. Joshua knew his part. And I could go on and on. Ultimately, Jesus Christ knew why he came. He knew his part. In Isaiah 22, verses 20 to 23, the Lord wanted someone to persuade Ahab to go to Ramoth Gilead so that what God wanted to be accomplished will be done. And after these discussions between all that were gathered, a spirit came forth and volunteered to persuade Ahab. The spirit said it will go forth as a lying spirit in the mouths of the prophets. The will of God will be accomplished, as Isaiah 55:11 states, So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing where I sent it. Is our role going to be one of obedience and submittance? Or are we going to continue to kick against the prick? Hallelujah. I remember the story of Saul before he became Paul, and he was going around persecuting the church, and he had an encounter on the road to Damascus, and he was asked, are you going to continue kicking against the prick? It is hard to kick against the prick. One preacher says, it is hard to box against God. You can't box with God. Our role this morning, as Matthew 28 verses 19 and 20 tells us, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. That seals it. That settles it. This is our role, to be witnesses. And when you're a witness, you are on display. Your life is on display. Your life should be an open book. Ecclesiastes 12, 13 tells us, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. That is our whole duty. See, we need to yield to the Spirit of God and let our role be one of the main character in the story of our lives. Be an active participant in the part that we are signed. We have to be present. We have to show up. It doesn't matter what we are going through. He promises that he will never fail us. He will never leave us comfortless. Because when he went back, he sent the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, to take us through. The Word of God says in Proverbs 3, verse 5 and 6, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he, God, will direct our path. When we say yes to the role that we are asked to play, God will be with us. We don't do it in our own strength. So don't be afraid of the role that you're playing. Don't be afraid to be the main character. Many of us said that, oh, I'm shy. Oh, I can't do this. I don't have it within me. Moses said, I can't speak. I stammer. But God gave him help. God always gives us help. But are we looking to the right people? Are we looking in the right direction? Some of us, our help is there, but because they don't look like what we want them to look like, because they don't speak like how we want them to speak, they don't have the status in life that we expect them to have, we disannul their help. We turn them away. We tell them, no, I'm okay, I'm fine, I don't need anything, and they're dying. What is your role on this morning? Hallelujah. Walk in our purpose and become the part that is fitly joined and held together by every joint with which is equipped. When each part is working properly, it makes the body grow so that it builds itself up in love. Ephesians 4:16. Everything we do all boils down to love. Because it was because of God's love for man that Jesus died for our sins. Yes, we all have issues. Yes, we all have problems. Every day you get up, it's a new reason for the enemy to come after us. When you're sold out for Christ, when you have said yes to God and the things of God, you will be picked on. You will be a target for the enemy. But what will be your role? Will you succumb to the devices of the enemy? Will you believe the lies on this morning? Hallelujah. The word of God says that do not take your liberty and use it as a cloak of bondage anymore. Because you have come out, because you have been delivered, because you have been set free, because you've come out of darkness into his marvelous light. This is a reason for you now to step up, take the main character role in your life and say, God, here am I. Be like Isaiah in the year that King Uzziah died. He said, I saw the Lord high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. And he says, here am I. I am a man of unclean lips. I am a man undone. He says, here am I, Lord, send me. Are you going to say this morning, God, I want to take the role. The play is being cast, and I am taking the role of the main character. I am auditioning, God, and here am I. Send me this morning. What is your role? Let's not frustrate the grace of God and make up our minds when it comes to the part we want to play as we continue to proclaim that we are children of the Most High God. In John 1, 11 and 12, it says, "He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name." Amen on this morning. He said he came to his own and his own received him. And he gave us a chance to become sons and daughters of the Most High. What is your role on this morning? What part are you playing? Are you scheming and lying and driving the nails in his hands after you have said yes to his will and to his way? If we are sons, and then we need to be sons and not be ashamed of the gospel of Christ. We need to pray out loud. We need to praise out loud. We need to live our Christian life out loud. We need not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth. If you believe on this morning, do not be ashamed to play the role that you've been cast in on this morning. What part are you playing? Are we driving the nails in his hands over again because of the lives we are living that does not imitate or emulate Christ? Are we crucifying him over again when we lie, when we cheat, when we have nasty attitudes, when we dislike each other, when we commit murder with our tongues? Hallelujah on this morning. What part are we playing? Are we being stumbling blocks to those that are around because of our attitudes, because of the things that we say? We never have an encouraging word. We are doom and gloom. And every time someone asks you, "How are you doing?" you have nothing too good to say. Not even the fact that you woke up this morning with your limbs moving of its own accord. No one had to get you out of bed. That is something alone to give thanks for. But as soon as someone says, "How are you this morning?" we go and we have a pity party. I have a philosophy that I live by. I just move on. I let it go and I move on. I always say, the enemy can't hit a moving target. Harder to hit. There is always going to be a praise on my lips. It doesn't matter the situation. I will find something to give God praise about. Because I know where I've been. I know where I'm coming from. Hallelujah. I've been lonely. I've been let down. I've been disappointed. I could have been one of the most bitter persons walking around. But I've made up my mind that serving God is all that matters. And he makes me smile every day. He puts a song in my heart. He puts a praise on my lips. I will forever be thankful and grateful for the things that God has done for me. I have a point of reference. When things get bad, I know where I draw my strength from. I go to the word, hallelujah. I go to the scriptures. I find solace. I find comfort in the word of God. Because when I begin to speak the word, it does something to my spirit. It does something to my inside. It rejuvenates me. It makes me joyful, hallelujah. It makes me want to sing. It makes me want to dance. It makes me want to shout of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for me. I speak to my spirit. I speak to my body. When I'm in pain and I'm achy, I speak to it and I say, "Let God arise in my body." Hallelujah. Oh God, I just want to say, Sister Angela, I listened to Pastor Greg when he did Ask the Pastor, and he was talking about speaking in tongues. The question came about speaking in tongues. And as I sat there and I listened to his explanation, I just got a joy, because I'm like, oh my God, when you speak in your heavenly language, you're speaking directly to God and he gives you instruction. And as you know, and I understand what he says, when we are being ostracized when we speak in tongues, they're like, "Oh, you sound like a fool," or "What are you saying?" And they don't understand and they don't realize it's because we're connecting with our Father. And while we connect, he gives us instruction and he rejuvenates our mind, our hearts, our spirit. And I got an extra oomph. I got an extra joy because I've started, you know, really speaking and singing and praying in my heavenly language, because that gives me the strength that I need. And the enemy does not know what I'm saying because I'm speaking directly to my Father. What is your role I have decided and made up my mind that my role will be the one of a witness. My life will be on display for the master. I will be the Bible that the world will see when they do not have a Bible. I will be the Bible the world will see when they have no church to go to. I will be the one that he's calling for. I will be the one. Hallelujah. I am gonna do this Christian disciple walk journey with everything that is within me. I am gonna give God my best. Because when it's all said and done, I want him to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into my rest. Hallelujah. He said the suffering of this present time is not going to be equal or cannot be compared to the glory that shall be revealed to us. I can't wait for when the plague comes to an end, the story of our lives come to an end, and the reward that we will receive at the end of it. Life maybe at time we need to check our life choices as we reevaluate the part that we have chosen to play in the kingdom of God. Are we going to be a part of the whole that is fitly joined together, that we work together in unity, in unison, to bring about the glory of God in this earth? Is our life going to be that of a glory carrier? When we open our mouths, will it show forth his praise? When we open our mouth, will it be a word spoken in season that will bring health and joy and just encouragement to someone along the way? But are we going to join the pity party? Are we going to join the gloom and doom and the naysayers? Are we going to be a part of the negative? Or do we want to be the ones that are positive, that will play the role, that will bring others to Christ? Because I do believe our lives is that of a rippling effect. It's a circle called the circle of life. If I do to you and you do to someone else and you pay it forward to someone else, it becomes a rippling effect that causes change. It takes one person to cause a change. It took one person to take prayer out of schools. It took one man to save the world, to pay the price for the sins of the world or mankind. It took one man to sin and one man to redeem man back to their Heavenly Father. What is your role? What role are you going to play? Hallelujah. Mighty God, I want to thank you this morning. That, Father God, we who have said yes to the role that we've been cast to play, that, Heavenly Father, we will lay down those things that so easily beset us, oh God. We will lay down self, oh God, so that you, God, will be seen in everything that we do. We pray this morning that you rejuvenate the spirit of our minds, our hearts, our spirits. Father God, that you bring us to a place of, oh God, submittance to you, total surrender. So, Father God, you can lead and direct us into our purpose and into the role that we are to live as we live for you, as we emulate and imitate Christ here on earth. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your blessings and your grace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.